The second important structure of short-term memory, according to Shiffrin and Atikisen, is short-term memory. Short-term memory is a very conscious, a very active types of memory, because it works like a computer screen. Short-term memory is a part of human memory that embraces the contents of our attention. When we are in a short-term memory, we human beings are very active. We are very conscious. We do things actively. Short-term memories are not brief replicas of the environmental message, which means in the short-term memory, we give meaning for those information which is coming through sensory memory. In short-term memory, we have perceptual analysis ability. We give meaning for the information. We give certain meaning for a particular information. So there is an information analysis, giving meaning, identifying the information properly. So our mind works actively in the short-term memory. So in the short-term memory, we have the potential of doing the following activities. For example, we think at the short-term memory, reading different books, speaking, drawing different kinds of pictures, problem-solving activities, all conscious activities are, all active activities are done by short-term memory. Here we have the name of short-term memory. When you read different books, you may have you may face or you may get different kinds of name which can refer the short-term memory. So the another name of short-term memory are like working memory, immediate memory, active memory, primary memory, and conscious memory. So all these five names are directly or indirectly representing the short-term memory. So working memory means our memory is active. That's why it is called as working memory. Immediate memory, we can use the memory immediately. Active memory, it is similar like working memory. Primary memory, conscious memory, all are related with short-term memory. Here we have four important characteristics of short-term memory. What are the characteristics which make short-term memory differ from another types of memory, which are sensory memory and long-term memory? The first thing is short-term memory is very active. It processes different active actions, processes new information in the workplace. Second, rapid accessibility. We can get information immediately. Information is ready to available, information is very ready and available for use, to use that information whenever we want. So information is found on the spot. Thirdly, or the third characteristic, the characteristics of memory is it preserves the temporal sequence of information. It maintains the information in a sequential manner for temporal period of time, that means for 30 seconds. By the way, information is stored or available in the short term memory only for 30 seconds. The last one is limited capacity. Unfortunately, short term memory has very limited capacity. Even though short term memory is very active, even though it works very consciously, even though it works by providing information lively, it has very limited capacity. That is the weak or the poor sides of short-term memory. According to George Miller, George Miller was the first psychologist who investigated the issue of human memory. So according to George Miller, he estimated the capacity of short-term memory, and he put that the maximum amount of containing different components or numbers are plus or minus 7. At a time, short-term memory contained only a minimum of 5 or a maximum of 9 components. Beyond 9 components or beyond 9 elements or things, short-term memory doesn't have the potential to use. Okay, according to most models of memory, we overcome this problem by grouping small groups information, that is chunking. Chunking is one of the mechanisms to improve our short-term capacity. As I told you, short-term memory has a capacity of plus 7 plus or minus 2. It can contain a minimum of 5 or a maximum of 9 components at a time. So to improve its capacity, we can use chunking. So chunking is a process of grouping or packing information into a higher order in order to improve our short-term memory. Chunking expands working memory by making large amount of information into meaningful category or meaningful packing or grouping. So the real capacity of short-term memory will be improved through chunking. Here we have different examples of chunking. Here I have a cell phone number. The numbers are very large, or 12 digits. So by chunking, we can hold the information in our mind. 09, 11, 20, 68, 78. This is a process of chunking. Put two things at a time, two things at a time, two things at a time, then possible to improve our memory. Similarly, short-term memory holds information like sounds, visuals, images, different words, different sentences, different pictures for 30 seconds only. The capacity of our mind, especially the short-term memory, is only 30 seconds. But if we do rehearsal and repetition, we can push those information from short-term memory to long-term memory. So rehearsal and repetition are the mechanisms or the techniques or the methods we have to use to push information or to transfer information from short term memory to the long term memory.